Good morning, student. Let us begin today's class on the topic structure of atom. So I hope till now you have understood the quantum numbers and are able to calculate the four quantum numbers for any given subshell. So let us begin with today's class. So today we are going to discuss about energies of orbitals, like by using energy level diagrams for hydrogen atom as well as multi-electron atoms. And we will also discuss about Ochsner principle, including N plus L rule. And we will also discuss about Pauli exclusion principle. So let us begin. So energies of orbitals using energy level diagrams of hydrogen atom as well as multi-electron atoms. So we had already discussed, students, that different subshells of the same main shell like K, L, M, N have different energies. And this is true only in case of multi-electron atoms, means having more than one electrons. So in case of hydrogen or hydrogen-like particles, which is containing only one electron, all these subshells are having same energy in case of hydrogen atom. But in case of multi-electron atoms, the different subshells of the same main shell have different energies. You can see over here the energy level diagram for a multi-electron atoms. You can see all the subshells over here, and they are arranged on the basis of increasing energy levels. And they are already arranged in this very manner. So in other words, we can conclude that whereas energy of different orbitals of hydrogen and hydrogen-like particles depend upon the value of principal quantum number only, that is N. But those of multi-electron atoms depends upon both principal quantum number as well as azimuthal quantum number, that is N and L. So we will discuss about this N plus L rule just after this. Okay, so energy level diagrams are such diagrams representing the arrangement of orbitals in order of their increasing energies. So this is known as energy level diagram. So using this, after seeing this energy level diagram for multi-electron atoms, we can draw out some important observations, which are as follows. So the first important observation is that the subshells of a particular shell do not have equal energies. For example, you can see over here 2s and 2p. They both are having principal quantum number 2, but they both are having different energies. That's why the subshells of a particular shell do not have equal energies. Both are having different, slightly different energy. 2s is having lower energy than 2p. So now coming towards the second observation, that is, in a particular shell, subshell with lower value of L has lower energy. Like suppose in second shell, suppose we are considering second shell belonging to 2s and 2p. So 2s, here L will be equals to 0, because we are knowing that for S subshell, L value is 0, and which is having lower energy than 2p. Why? You can see over here, P is L value of P subshell is 1. We had already discussed the quantum number. L is having 1. So that's why we can say that in a particular shell, subshell with lower value of L, L2S having L 0, it is having lower energy as compared to 2P. Similarly, we can also say, for suppose if we are considering third shell. So third shell, you can see over here, 3S, 3p and 3d, third shell belonging to these three subshells. So their energies are in the order of 3s lower energy, then 3p, then 3d. You can see over here. So it's this proves that L for 3s is, L value is 0, then for L value of 3p is 1, and for 3d is 2. So the increasing order of energy will be 3s greater than 3p greater than 3d, depending upon the L value. So I hope it's clear. Now the third important observation is, for the same value of N, the difference between energies of S and P subshell is small. whereas between P and D subshells it is large, and so on. It's very simple. And one more observation we can see over here after seeing the diagram, that is, as the value of n increases, means principal quantum number increases, the subshells of lower shell may have higher energy than that of the higher shell. For example, we can see over here 3D has higher energy than 4S. Instead of having principal quantum number, more principal quantum number, 4S is still having lower energy than 3D. So we can say the fourth observation. We can see over here, we can note down one thing, that in case of hydrogen atom, the energies of the orbitals are in the order like 1s less energy than 2s, which will be equals to 2p, because just now we have discussed that in case of hydrogen or hydrogen like particles, they have the same energy. Have the same energy means the subshells which are belonging to the main subshell, main shell, they are having the same energy. So this is the energy level diagram. And in case of hydrogen atom, the only force of interaction is the force of attraction between the negatively charged electron and the positively charged nucleus. But in case of multi-electronic atom, in addition to the force of attraction between the electrons and nucleus, there are also forces of repulsion among the electrons. So the atom is stable because the net forces of attraction are greater than the forces of repulsion. So later on we will discuss about this forces of attraction and repulsion as a shielding effect. So I hope this energy level diagram is clear to all of you. So let us proceed towards the filling of orbitals in atoms. So the filling of electrons in the orbitals of different atoms takes place according to the following rule, that is of Bohr principle. Just now we had also discussed about the energy level diagram, means how these subshells, which subshell having lower energy and which is having higher energy. So these are all, this is also an important fact over here. So of Bohr principle, the word of Bohr in German means building up. So the building up of orbitals means the filling up of orbitals with electrons. So this principle states that in the ground state of atoms, the orbitals are filled in order of their increasing energies. Just now we had also discussed about the increasing energy levels. So in other words, we can say that electrons first occupy the lowest energy orbital available to them and enter into higher energy orbitals only when the lower energy orbitals are completely filled. So this is of Bohr principle. So we can say that the order in which the energies of the orbitals increase, and hence the order in which the orbitals are filled, is as follows, like 1s, then 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, and so on. You can see over here the order is written over here in the increasing energy level. And for memorizing it, one trick is there, like you have to write in horizontal manner all the main subshell. For if n is equals to 1, then only 1s is there present. For n is equals to 2, 2s and 2p. So you have to write in the same manner. And after writing that, you have to draw a straight line passing through those subshells. Like for 1s, only 1s, you can cut over it. And then for 2s, again straight line. And if you are starting from 3s, then 2p will also meet in the same path. Then you have to cross both of them. Again, similarly for 4s towards 3p, it is also crossing that orbitals. And after that, we can see that in this very manner, you can see the diagram as well, the arrow direction. So starting from 1s, you are moving through the direction, through that very direction, coming towards 2s. And after 2s, then again, if you are moving towards the line, then we are coming to 2p. And then again to 3s. And then similarly, if you are moving further, then 3p, then 4s, then 3d. So this is also a way to memorize this increasing energy level. And in this very manner, only the electrons are filled in the orbitals, in the subshells. So I hope this is clear to all of you. This is known as of Bohr principle. So alternatively, The order of increasing energies of the various orbitals can be calculated on the basis of n plus l rule. So let us discuss. I had also told you previously n plus l rule. So what is that n plus l rule? The energy of an orbital depends upon the sum of values of principal quantum number n and the azimuthal quantum number l. This is called n plus l rule. So according to this rule, in neutral isolated atom, the lower the value of n plus l for an orbital, lower is its energy. Means if the value of n plus l is lower for an orbital, then it will be of lower energy as compared to the other one. However, if two different types of orbitals have the same value of n plus l, suppose for two different orbitals the value of n plus l is same, then the orbital with lower value of n has the lower energy. Means then that very orbital which is having the lower principal quantum number will have the lower energy. So for illustration, you can see over here for your better understanding, we have taken over here the different orbitals 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s and so on. And for that, you are able to write down value of n, that is principal quantum number, and value of l as well. I hope value of n and l you all are able to write it down. So that is principal quantum number. After writing principal quantum number, l value depends upon the subshell, that is s and p. For s it is 0, for p it is 1, and for d it is 2. So written over here, and after that we have calculated n plus l value, means we are summing both of them. 1 plus 0, then it is coming 1. 2 plus 0, it is coming 2. 2 plus 1, similarly 3. So for the first thing, suppose if you are considering 1s and 2s, so the value of n plus l for 1s is less compared to 2s. So that's why you can say that 1s orbital having the lower energy than 2s orbital. Now coming towards 2p and 3s, you can see over here that 2p orbital having n plus l value 3, and 3s orbital is also having n plus l value 3. So both n plus l values are same. Now according to rule, which one of them will be of lower energy? 2p, because the principal quantum number, means the value of n, is lower for 2p as compared to 3s. So we can say that 2p, n is equal to 2, has lower energy than 3s, which is having n is equal to 3. Now similarly, if we are proceeding further for 3p and 4s as well, 3p is also n plus l value 4 and 4s as well 4. So we can say simply here as well that 3p is having lower energy than 4s because of less principal quantum number for 3p, that is 3. Similarly for 3d and 4p. So I hope n plus l rule is clear to all of you. So from this description given in this very table, we can say that the energies of various orbitals increase in the order as follows, like 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p and so on, like this. So I hope this is clear to all of you. So let us proceed further towards the Pauli exclusion principle. So from a study of the quantum numbers, Wolfgang Pauli, a German physicist, in 1925 put forward a principle known after his name as Pauli exclusion principle. It states that no two electrons in an atom can have the same set of four quantum numbers. Means if we are considering any atom, so if we are considering two electrons of that very particular atom, then they do not have the same set of all four set of quantum numbers, same set of quantum numbers. So this is the statement given by Wolfgang Pauli. So if it means if one electron in an atom has some particular values for the four quantum numbers, then all the other electrons in that atom are excluded from having the same set of values. Why this is so? It is because of this reason that this principle is called exclusion principle. Thus it follows, we can say that in an atom,
any two electrons may have the same values for any of the three quantum numbers, but the fourth must be different. Now, if we are considering any particular orbital which is described by three quantum numbers, that is N, L or M. For example, if we are taking 3s orbital, so for 3s, we are having N is equals to 3 and L is equals to 0 and M is equals to 0 as well. So, we can say that for each value of M, there are two values of spin quantum number, that is plus half and minus half. Therefore, 3s orbital can have two electrons, one with quantum numbers N is equals to 3, L is equals to 0, M is equals to 0 and S is equals to plus half. And the other electron with quantum numbers N is equals to 3, L is equals to 0, M is equals to 0, but S will be different, that is minus half. Because if you are considering only one orbital, then obviously both the electrons are of opposite spin. So similarly, we can take any two orbitals and then the same thing will happen. So you can see over here as well some calculations of maximum number of electrons that can be accommodated in a shell, its subshells and orbitals. So you can see over here, subshells are being given 1s, 2s, 2p and then you are able to write down its principal quantum number, that is n, as well as azimuthal quantum number or orbital quantum number L, you can also able to write it down, and then magnetic as well for spin as well. After writing for 1s orbital, if we have to find it out the total number, maximum number of electrons, then what will be the maximum number of electrons in that for 1s? It will be 2, because only two spin you can see over here, plus half and minus half. Again, for 2s, similarly, we are having 2 electrons. But for 2p, you can see over here, 2p, the magnetic quantum numbers are 3. It is having 3 magnetic quantum numbers, minus 1, 0 and plus 1. And for each value of m, for each value of ml, we are having 2 electrons. Means for each, if we are considering ml is equals to minus 1, then also we are having 2 spin quantum number, plus half, minus half. Again for 0, that is plus half, minus half. Again for plus 1, it is plus half and minus half. So ultimately it is giving 6 number of electrons. So we can say that for main shell, that is 2, n is equals to 2, it is having a total of 8 electrons. Because for main shell 2, it is containing 2s and 2p both. So it is containing a total of 8 electrons. Similarly, if you are considering for main shell, suppose M, and means N is equals to 3, then we are having orbitals 3s, 3p and 3d. Similarly, we can write it down, the principal quantum number for all of them, the azimuthal quantum number L values, their ML values and their MS value as well. So after writing, we can calculate for 3s, 2 electrons, for 3p, 6 electrons because we are having 3 ml values, and for 3d, total of 10 electrons because here we are having ml values, 5 ml values. So for each ml values, we are having 2 electrons. So 10, so 10 plus 6 plus 2, 18. So similarly, if we are going to continue this calculation for n is equals to 4, then it will lead to 32 electrons. So I hope now it's clear to all of you about the calculation of maximum number of electrons that can be accommodated in any shell. So thus, it may be also be calculated by using some certain formulas which is as given. Like for calculating the total number of shells, subshells in nth shell, that is n. And for the number of orbitals in a subshell, that is being calculated by using 2l plus 1. And for calculating maximum number of electrons in a subshell, that is being given by 2 into 2l plus 1. And for number of orbitals in nth shell, it will be equals to n square. And for maximum number of electrons in nth shell, all of you are knowing that is given by 2n square. So this is the formula which you can use directly to calculate all these. Or otherwise, you can just simply write in the quantum number in terms of quantum numbers to calculate the maximum number of electrons. So you can use either of the method. So let us proceed towards the another definition of poly-exclusion principle. Poly-exclusion principle also states that an orbital can have maximum two electrons and these must have opposite spin. Means in after the given of that very statement regarding to quantum numbers, it also states that an orbital can have maximum two electrons and these must have opposite spins. You can see over here for illustration, it's a simple statement. Like if you are considering 1s, 2s, any orbitals we are considering. So obviously we are knowing that in any subshell, particularly if you are considering 1s, then the two electrons, it is accommodating only two electrons. And those two electrons should have, must have opposite spin. Means one principal quantum number, it is having one. But for spin quantum number, it should have plus half and minus half. Like suppose you can see over here, for in 2s subshell, the both the spins are in upward direction. So it is not possible. So this is what Pauli exclusion principle states, that an orbital can have maximum two electrons, that we are knowing. But those two electrons must have opposite spin. Like the second one for 2s, it is totally correct. One electron is in upward direction having spin quantum number plus half, and the another one is having minus half. So this is all about Pauli exclusion principle and Hofbauer principle about the energy level diagram. So I hope it's clear to all of you. In our next class, we will discuss more principles, and using these principles, we will write down the electronic configuration of elements. So let us discuss one question based on it. That is, the question is like this. What is the total number of orbitals associated with the principal quantum number, that is n is equals to 3? So you have been given n is equals to 3, so you are able to calculate. So suppose for n is equals to 3 means L is equals to 0, 1, 2. That is, there are 3 subshells designated as 3s, 3p, 3d. For 3s, just now we have discussed L can be 0 and M can be 0. So that is, it is having only one orbital. For 3p subshell, L is 1 and M will be minus 1 to plus 1. That is 3 orbitals. Again, for 3d subshell, L is 2 and M value will be minus 2 to plus 2. That is 5 orbitals. So the total number of orbitals present in the shell with N is equals to 3 will be, we can add all of them. That is 1 plus 3 plus 5. So we are getting 9. So this is how we can calculate by using the simple method, or we can use directly the formula. So alternatively, we can directly use the formula of calculating the number of orbitals present in the n shell is given by n square. So here n is 3, so we are putting value 3 over here. So 3 square gives us answer 9. So directly you can use the formula as well. So today we have discussed about filling of orbitals in an atom, that is using energy level diagram, Hofbauer principle, and we have also discussed about Pauli exclusion principle. So thank you, students.